wrestling, we have a shoe to hold on to, so people can't slide their feet out as easily. You still can, but it requires like a lot more space. But a lot of times when people get into MMA, the person gets a single leg on. If you can turn your knee down, my leg gets progressively smaller, so I can slide it out, especially when you get any kind of sweat in there or if you're in no-gi competitions. So people don't trust shooting single legs as much as they do like a blast double or different techniques. But the way I finish it, I feel like it works pretty successfully. You have to get it a lot smoother, you have to try it a lot, and then you have to get really high height with this as fast as you possibly can. So anytime that I get in on a single leg on people that I'm fighting, my first job is to not let this knee get turned down and get that foot as high as possible. Okay, so now they're thinking about their balance, they're not thinking about striking me, they're not thinking about getting out of it, okay? So when I get in my single leg, I can drive into them, I drop to the ankle, and I get it high, okay? Right now, he is worrying about his balance. If he does even try to strike or anything, he's not gonna be able to do everything very effectively. But what he can't do is turn his knee down. If he gets his knee past this and starts turning his knee down, it's gonna be really, really hard for me to hold him, okay? So I have to stay above the knee, and I have to control that foot or that ankle, okay? So when I get it on my single leg, I attack the ankle. I'm not just like holding it with like space. I'm pinching everything in and I'm above that knee. Now what I like to do is I keep this really tight, like you guys are like flexing for your girlfriend in the crowd. And I get my hips underneath it. I want to move my hips as close to his hips as possible. Okay? So out here, he can push away from me, create distance, do different things to attack me. See, he's grabbing me, he's attacking me. But when I lift this and get my hips in, I immediately reach the end points of his balance. He's already almost tipping over, but I collapse his body better. He can't manage the distance. So all I have to do is hook my foot on the mat and let him fall over it, okay? So I don't want to kick and reach with my foot because then I'm gonna be off balance too, okay? Very balanced people can end up on top of you if you're not careful with how you finish the single leg. So I get into my single leg, I drop down, and I get that foot high. It's my first job, and I make sure this knee stays pointing up to the ceiling. I get my hips underneath and close to his. If I'm out here, and I try to kick the foot, I'm losing my balance, so, and I'm not as strong. Yeah, he can keep distance, he wants space. I wanna get closer. Lock my arm in like a bicep curl, get my hips close to their hips. All I have to do is hook my foot, and I'll fall over it. Then you can go to whatever way you want to cover that, a pass to a strike, whatever you like to do. But for the other people who do other sides, we will do it to the other side for you also. So I get in on my single leg. My backhand is the one that's on top, like I showed last week. I drop to the ankle and I get it as high as I can, as quickly as possible. Knee stays pointed to the ceiling. I'm controlling the foot and I get my hips close to his hips. I can walk. Just step my foot, he goes over. That's for making me do drills. And this stupid live video. But whatever, I guess I'll do it. I have no choice.
Every Friday at 6 p.m.
Every Friday at 6 p.m.
Eastern time.
Yay! Okay, I survived. Thank you everybody that tuned in. I appreciate it, even though you're making my life harder, because it's gonna just encourage them to make you do this more. But I am happy to share different techniques with you guys.
Cool. All right. Thanks, people.
You got save.
Where to save, though?
And live video.
So, in the first?
Yeah.